In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make attention-grabbing thumbnails so more people are gonna click on your videos. And we're starting right now. I was just helping a friend of mine polish up his YouTube channel, and one of the first things I noticed was that he wasn't using YouTube's custom thumbnail feature. And as you might have noticed, even YouTube is pushing people to customize their thumbnails because it's an extremely effective way to get people to look at your videos. So of course, I told him that he needed to start using this feature, and he told me that he didn't even know that he could. He thought that the custom thumbnail feature was only something for the big channels because he didn't see it anywhere in his admin panel. And another thing that he didn't know is that he didn't see it in his admin panel because he hadn't verified his account yet. So we got his channel verified, I gave him a thumbnail template, and I went over a handful of concepts with him, the same concepts I'm gonna go over with you here in a minute, about how his thumbnail should look. And now that he's using thumbs on his channel, he's getting more views faster with every single video that he uploads. Here are the concepts. When making your thumbs, make the text as big and easy to read as possible. To accomplish this, what you need to do is stay away from small fonts, thin fonts, or fonts that are just too fancy or obviously hard to read. You can use those kind of fonts on smaller, not important text, like a small word of how to or something like that, but your main topic has to be obvious at a glance. You also need to make sure that your graphic looks good at a small size and a large size, because when YouTube puts it in the sidebar, you want people to be able to see it easily and understand what your video is about. And when it's displayed on something big and at full size, you also want it to look great and not blurred or pixelated at that size either. Another one that you need to do is make sure you use color somewhere. It can be a vibrant photo, it can be colored text, a colored background, whatever it is, just make sure you use color so that people will be more drawn to it. Just remember, you're trying to get as much attention as possible to your thumbnail so that people are gonna be drawn to it when they see it in the sidebar and click on it so they can watch your video. Let me show you what I mean. The thumb on the left sucks. The thumb on the right demands more attention because it's colorful and clearly states what the video is about. Take that same exact thumbnail and add just a little bit of color, and you're really gonna stand out from the others. If you're wanting to brand yourself, you can add your picture to the thumb, and you can even go a step further by having elements on your thumb to help people identify that it's your video at a glance. I just recently started doing that myself by adding a little red strip with my name on it to all my thumbnails. I'll let you know how it works out. If you have a channel where just using a photo will do the trick, or you just don't want to use text, make sure that it's still attention grabbing and make sure that it's relevant to your video, because when somebody gets to your video, you want to make sure that they stay there and watch it instead of thinking that they fell for some clickbait. That's it for the concepts. Now, let me show you how to make them. And real quick before we do, I also want to let you know that there's a link down in the description where you can get some pre-made graphics for your channel in the event that you need them. To make attention grabbing thumbnails, the first thing you want to do is go to File, New. Make sure that your canvas is set to 1920 by 1080 pixels and your resolution is set to 72 and click OK. Then go to your paintbrush icon here, click it, and you might see a gradient icon or a 3D material drop tool icon. If you do, just long press it and click your paint bucket tool. Go down to your color picker, pick whatever color that you want to make your background, click OK, and then click anywhere in the background and you have your background color. Next thing you want to do is go to File, Open, find a computer you want to use on your, find a picture that you want to use on your computer, click Open. Then you want to move your tab here, just kind of pull it down to pull this picture to where it's up, to where you can see the two separate projects, and then click on your Move tool, drag this picture over. All you have to do is hold down your left mouse button and pull it onto the canvas of your thumb. Click that to close. Now you can see over here in the layers palette, you have your pick layer and you have your background layer. So I'm going to have my pick layer selected, click on my move tool, and I'm going to scoot this guy over here to the side. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose my type tool. I'm going to change my color to white, and I'm going to pick a font. I already have it selected, but I'm going to make sure that I have a nice attention grabbing font, and in this example I'm going to choose Impact Regular, and I'm going to click anywhere on the canvas and I'm going to type, this is my, click on the move tool to commit. I'm going to move this into place. I'm going to hit Control T on my keyboard. Hold down my shift key. When I hold down my shift key, this keeps my ratio together. I'm just going to click on a corner and drag this to be bigger. And then I'm going to go over here to my layers palette, right click, duplicate layer. This is my, click on the text tool again, change that to brand new. Click on the move tool to commit. Control T, hold down my shift key, and let's bring it down to about there. And then I'm gonna right click again on that on my layers palette, hit duplicate layer again, hold down my shift key, move it down, click on my text tool, and then type in thumb. Then I'm gonna hit my move tool again to commit, control T. As you can tell, that seems to be the pattern, and then I'm gonna make this bigger right there like that. Click on my move tool to commit, hit apply, and I'm gonna scoot this down. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to come over to my layers palette. I'm gonna make sure I click on my top layer, and I'm gonna hold down my shift key, and I'm gonna click on my bottom text layer. And then I'm just gonna select all three, and I'm gonna move these into a better place. And I'm going to hit control T on my keyboard with all three of them selected. And I'm gonna drag these out to make them bigger. I'm actually gonna move my guy over just a little bit here in a second. Okay, once I have that the size that I want, I'm gonna hit my move tool again, hit apply. Now I'm gonna select my pick layer. I'm gonna scoot him over just a tad. Okay. Now I'm gonna go to my thumb layer, my thumb text layer, which is this text right here. And I'm going to go to my effects panel, and I'm going to go up to stroke. That's gonna open this dialog box here. And as you can see, it put a black frame or a black border around my text. I'm gonna make that a little bit bigger. And you can do this with any color. You change the color right here. You just click on that color, and you can change it to anything that you want. Then I'm gonna put a drop shadow on it, and I'm going to set my angle to 135. Personal preference, I just like how that looks better. I'm gonna pull my distance out. As you can see, the shadow appearing behind the text there. Make my size a little bit bigger. And you can do this in a bunch of different ways for different effects. Like I can pull my distance out and make my size small and make my opacity 100, change this to normal, and it gives it like a 3D-ish kind of effect there. Yeah, that's actually kind of cool. I'm going to keep that. Then I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to right click on my text layer that I just edited. Hit copy layer style. I'm going to click on my brand new text. And I'm going to hold down my control key and click on this is my text. Right click, paste layer style. And that takes care of the other layers as well. Now, as you can see, I have this unflattering line here between my guy and my background. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on my pick layer, I'm gonna go to my eraser tool, I'm gonna go to my brush settings, I'm gonna make sure my hardness is set really low, because if it's hard this way, you get a really hard edge. If it's pulled all the way down, you get a really soft feathered edge. So I'm gonna put it around 47%. My size is good here, we'll do around 340, 350, oops. Then the next thing I'm gonna do is just come over and I'm gonna lightly erase. Oh, one more thing. As you can see, my flow is set to 45. I'm actually gonna take that down to 26. And that's basically how much of a fade it's gonna do, or how strong the effect is. And I'm just gonna blend him in just a little bit. You can go through the trouble of cutting him out where if you watch the advanced version of this tutorial, you'll see that. I'm just gonna fade him out just a little bit around here to kind of blend everything in. Okay, and then there you would have a exportable thumbnail that is definitely viewable and easily readable at large size. At large size, and when it is small, like on YouTube, you can easily read what that says. So you have this thumbnail, and if you want to add more attention to it, you can of course go back into your layer style panel. To do that, you can either double click the text layer, or any layer for that matter, or go down to your effects option down here. I'm going to go to color overlay. And as you can see right away, that just screams out at you. But I'm going to change the color by clicking on the color option. I'm going to click only web colors. Turn that off. And now you can see that that really stands out, especially there against that blue. So if you compare the two,
huge, huge difference as far as the attention that those will grab. And this is exportable. So, I mean, this thumb would be ready to go. So to export it, you go to File, Save for Web. And from your drop-down list here, you want to make sure that you have PNG 24 selected. And for these, because it's a full thumbnail, there's no transparency. So you don't have to have transparency selected, but I export a lot of transparent stuff, so I'm going to leave mine selected just so I don't forget to do that after this tutorial. And then I'm going to hit Save. And then I'm going to save it wherever my thumb is. Now, you can go a little bit further, and you can click on your text layers, and you can hit Control T on your keyboard. And if you want to give it kind of like a wonky look, you just tilt it just a little bit, hit the Apply, and go to the next one, Control T on my keyboard. And you can see as I get close to it here, the little icon that pops up to let me know that I'm getting ready to rotate this little icon right here. And when I go around the different corners, you can see it kind of turns with me. But all I do is I hold down my left mouse button, and then I just kind of scoot that around, hit Apply, and then I'm going to do the same thing to this layer, Control T, tilt it just a little bit. Now I'm going to rearrange my layers here just so my shadow is kind of overlapping the text that's underneath it. So I'm going to move this up, and I'm going to move this up. So as you can see, it just kind of gives it a little bit more of a 3D effect. So now I'm going to zoom out again, and you can see still extremely readable, very easy to read, bright colors, attention grabbing, and he's also kind of crazy looking, so also attention grabbing.
That's all there is to putting a custom thumbnail together. And after you do two or three of these things, because you already know where everything is, you can put these together really, really fast. And one thing that I do is I have a template that I use, and I basically use that template as my starting point so that anytime that it's time to make a new thumbnail, I just open my template and then I'll change the font or change the text around, drop in a new picture or whatever. But I've already got a general idea of how I'm gonna lay everything out. And another thing that I wanna mention is, if you already have a bunch of videos on YouTube, you can still change the thumbnail graphics anytime that you want to through your video manager. Once you're in your video manager, all you have to do is click on the video that you wanna edit, hover over your current thumb, and then it's gonna give you the option to change it. Then you just upload your new thumb from your computer, and voila, you have a new thumbnail. So start using custom thumbnail graphics on your videos as soon as you can, and I guarantee that you're gonna see results from it. For more tools and resources that you can use in your online or offline business, click the link in the description below to access my VIP area, where you can find royalty-free music that you can use on anything, pre-made graphics that you can use anywhere, how-to guides, and more. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.